will never be the same.
Bless the Lord, beloved, and welcome to an exciting day on the Voice of Resurrection devotional. We are learning consecrations for power, how God brings us into the reality of His kingdom, the grace of God transforming me, strengthening me, empowering me. Hallelujah. Beloved, sometimes these things happen instantaneously. Other times it's a gradual process. But the key is that your heart remains with the Lord. Whether it's instantaneous or it's a process, He's working it out. He's working it out. He's perfecting that which concerns you in the mighty name of Jesus. And He's perfecting that which concerns me. Glory to God. Let us read the book of Acts, chapter 1, verse 4 again. And being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem. Can you imagine those that miss church? If you have missed this meeting with Jesus, hallelujah. I mean legitimately. Those of you, at the slightest thing, you don't come to church. It's raining, then you don't come to church. It's too cold, then you don't come to church. You're going through a financial problem, you don't come to church. Somebody said to me, well, I couldn't come to church because I didn't have money for gas, and I was reserving the gas in my car for work. I just burst out laughing. I said, beloved, that's what will guarantee that your financial problems will continue. You serve money more than God. You go to church. Let the chips fall where they may. And then you will be going to your car and thanking God that you finally had faith to put Him first. He will tell somebody to give you $100. You go fill your tank. I have money left over. That's the way this kingdom works. But we are so in our flesh and in our own head and in our humanity that we miss all the miracles. All the miracles. I lived it and I know it and I'm living it every day. When I tell people I've never had fundraising one time, in our ministry, don't believe it, but it's true. In the dimensions, it's working. Huh? The kingdom is a blast. The other areas where I'm still trying to understand it, it's a struggle. You see? So you need to learn it area by area because the kingdom principles exist for every issue and every area in your life. But the overarching, I don't know what other word to use. The number one thing in this kingdom is that God must be first. First! Seek ye first the kingdom. Put Him first. That's the only way things work in this kingdom. If He says gather, you gather. Don't gather, don't gather. Hallelujah. You listen to the Holy Spirit and obey. See, being assembled together with them, commanded them. You notice the language of the kingdom is commandment, no suggestions. The problem with us in America is we think we're in a democracy. But in the kingdom of God, it's not a democracy. Even the American democracy is not a democracy because they do whatever they want and they tell you whatever they want to tell you. And you go and vote, but you don't even elect the president. The Electoral College does. So what are you really voting? And you believe the lies they tell you because we're too lazy to study or research or pray to listen to God. Our emotions becloud us. We vote against the things we believe in the Word of God. And then the evil in society keeps perpetrating because we are serving money. Who will prophesy to us? We get offended. We vote color. We vote all these wrong things. We don't pray. And then we pray and say God is speaking things that those of us that hear from God know is as far as the east is from the west. The proof is that what God has spoken to us keeps coming to pass. And then people don't repent for hearing error. May God help this generation. In Jesus' name. He says, when being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which said he, you have heard of me. If you missed yesterday's devotional, listen to it. You have a promise. You have a promise, beloved. For John truly baptized with water. John truly baptized with water, but ye shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost not many days hence. Beloved, I wish I had an hour to preach this to you, because so many of you are incarcerated with the yesterdays of God. I was speaking to a man recently, and he kept telling me what God did for him in the past through this one avenue. And I was saying, you can go further. He was indignant. He said, no, that's your opinion. This is my way. He said, John truly baptized with water, but God is ready to do something greater, something mightier, something more powerful. I give this testimony. I used to go to the ministry I was a part of, and then we tarried for the Holy Ghost all night long. I mean, we'll pray all night long, and then a few people will receive and we'll be rejoicing. And this kept on going, and I kept seeking the baptism with the Holy Spirit, and I couldn't receive. I kept living in frustration. Eventually, my brother prayed for me, and I received to some measure, and then the explosion came later when I used my little measure to go bless somebody else. But then one day, somebody came along and said, you know, you don't need to do this anymore. People were indignant and arrogant. How can you say that what we're doing is not it? That's human nature, pride. He said, no, the Holy Ghost has already come. And any believer can minister to you who is in faith, and you will be filled with the Holy Ghost. You don't need to tarry all night long. Of course, we reject it. People rejected it, not me. And the Lord blessed me, and I started flowing in the thing. I was in one meeting, as I've given testimony, where I prayed for three people and they received the Holy Spirit. And when I found out that all the others wanted the Holy Spirit, I prayed over the people that just received and asked them to lay hands on each other. And they all started imparting the Holy Spirit on each other until they were all filled with the Holy Spirit. And this happened within 30 minutes. We didn't have to tarry all night. John truly baptized with water, but ye shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost not many days hence. God will do a new thing in your life that he hasn't done before. Move on with him. Yes, you experienced the water baptism. Now it is time for the baptism of the Holy Spirit, in case you're in the denominations that don't believe. But in principle, beloved, whatever great thing the Lord has done in the past, he is ready to do something greater, something new in Jesus' name. Make it a blast in 2015 by remaining open to the Holy Ghost, by remaining open to whatever he has purposed for you, that not many days hence, let your miracle break. Not many days hence, let God visit you. Not many days hence, may your breakthrough show up on the earth in the mighty name of Jesus. Glory to God. Ooh, I felt that leave me. Glory! Hallelujah! Blessed be the name of the Lord. Somebody received a miracle. You need to write us and let us know. I felt it leave me. Glory to God in Jesus' name. Not many days hence, your miracle has broken, will break. Thank God for it. I can't go any further. I feel the presence and the grace of God in this moment. And Lord, we thank you for this miracle. We thank you for this blessing. In Jesus' name. Amen and amen. We love you. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye. The Lord is waiting on you.